with Rob McElnea at the MCN XL show in London. Rob, there's a recession on, in case you haven't noticed, but you seem to have the hugest team ever in BSB this year. What's going on?
Well, we've had a tough time, I guess, since the end of the year, and we've managed to find new partners, new sponsors. We've sold it all pretty tight and tried to get the whole thing going. We've got riders coming with new backers to stack it all up. And really, although it's a pretty big team, we're still pretty much same size staff-wise and so on, the same sort of guys. And we've had to sort of spread what we can sell to get enough budget to put the whole thing together. So I wouldn't say it's big totally intentionally, but it's worked out that way. As it happened, we've got some really good lads, and I think we've got a great complement of experience and youth. So you know, everybody's really quite excited.
So we've got Chris Walker and Graeme Gowland in the blue corner, and we've got Michael Rutter on a superbike and Dan Linford on a 600 in the red corner. How's it all going to... It's going to be a lot of rivalry going on in there.
Which hopefully will be good. I mean, I think we've had a couple of days with everybody together and everybody's getting on really well. And the niggle of the blue and red thing is getting going now. And I'm sure Alistair Kennedy, the Northwest guy, is keen to sort of stir that up and keep that flavour going. The hospitality will be interesting with splitting that up into two types of customers in red and blue. And I'm sure we're going to have a lot of fun with it. But ultimately, we're going to have two guys who are going to push each other. We've not had that for a long, long time. We've put a lot of effort into youth with Tommy Hill through the years and other guys, and last year didn't quite work out with Carl Harris. So this year we've got the strongest team we've ever had. We've got two guys who they get on well, but I don't think they're particularly that friendly, if you like. So you know that's going to have a healthy competitiveness in the team.
This is Chris Walker and Michael Rutter.
Yeah, I mean they've been around forever, both of the guys. They're totally different types of characters, but you know we've got a team where we can give all of the riders totally everything we possibly can, totally even, transparent team, all works totally openly. So it will be a case of who can get one over each other. And I think what we've not had in the past is two solid riders who can push each other, help us develop the bike, and at the same time we've got a couple of young guys snapping at the heels, catching anything they drop off the table and information and experience. So we've never been this excited for a long, long time. You know, and the new bike obviously as well, his timing is perfect.
Northwest 200 Coca-Cola Zero team with Michael Rutter. He's coming off like arguably one of the best bikes in BSB we've ever seen, and he's going to be on a four-cylinder bike. How do you think he's going to cope with that?
I don't think he's going to ever have been in a team like ours. I think through wherever he's been, and he's been obviously with some great teams, I don't think he's ever going to experience what we can give for him, and I think we'll get the best out of him mentally. With Michael, you've got probably one of the most natural riders we've ever seen. You know, he's an absolute professional on the track, and the way he's disciplined, once when he's riding at his best, there's only a few guys who ride like that. And again, that's going to help Chris, he's going to help Dan. I think, you know, what each one of these guys needs is there in my team. So whether the discussion is getting all working together, but I'm sure Graham's going to pick a bit of what Chris does, and Rutter's going to pick a bit of what Chris does, and so on. So I think we've got a real good chance of getting them all riding well. Rutter's got to give up a Factory Ducati, but if we've been instrumental in getting rid of those Ducatis, that really suits me fine. You know, so, but saying that, the timing of Rutter moving to a four-cylinder couldn't be any better, because this is not a normal four-cylinder he's going to be riding.
Yeah.
You know, this is a brand new Yamaha. We've got experience of what's coming. We did a similar sort of engine firing order in 2005, and it blew us away with the feedback we got, the rider feel they got from that. So we know what the riders are going to feel. They don't know what's coming. You know, we do. So we're really excited about that. I've obviously thought about it long and hard, and everything's positive, and all the cogs fit together. Walker's coming back to a team like ours is a bit rough and aggressive. This bike will suit him absolutely fine. Rutter's coming to a team with a four cylinder bike. It's a four cylinder, what I feel a bit like a Ducati. It's soft power, that suits him fine. Graeme Gallo stepping up to Superbike, and it's not a monster anymore. It's a bike where he ain't going to scare him.
Yeah.
You know, he tested our bike at Cadwell last year, and he did scare him because they are.
But he was fast.
He was fast, and he looked great, and he listened, and he in a short period he had on the bike, he definitely impressed us. But we know what that bike, even with the electronics package we have now, that bike is still a bit of a monster. Mm. It won't be that bike anymore. Sure. You know, so all in little bits, I think, gives us a real good foundation to really get the best out of all of those guys. For all of the team, to come off the back of a year like last year, for us now to be sat here in February with the bikes nearly built and a team around us like this, it's you know, it's a real good turnaround. It's going to be tight. We're going to look great. You know, we're going to have... We're going to be a very big part of the show, and it's very, very much a selling year. We want to try and do the best possible we can with all our sponsors, and we want them to stay with us, and we want them to grow, get through this tough time, and hopefully we put a bit of a spring in people's step with what we've done so far this winter. There's been so much doom and gloom that everybody's reading positive things about us, and you know, even the day you gave us the day and come out with a bit of fun, you could feel a good. There was a good feeling in the team, and hopefully it'll knock on to our sponsors. We've got a big press launch plan later in the year. We've got to really just make, like we said earlier, we've got to do, this year's got to be huge value for money for everybody involved. We've got to go the extra mile with all our sponsors. So,
okay, cheers, Rob.
All right.